Hey folks, my name is Jared Manninen, and I'd like to welcome you to my monthly newsletter. At the beginning of each month, I publish a newsletter filled with photos, videos, artwork, links to my other projects, and an essay that I hope will provide food for thought and a starting point for meaningful conversation. These newsletters essentially allow me to compile all of the work I produced during the past month and share it in a convenient location. Keep in mind, however, that these video versions of my newsletters have been modified from their original format. And although I've been publishing my monthly newsletter since 2017, I've only started producing them in this video format since 2022. So if you want to read any of my previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com. Thoughts about learning how to learn. As far as I know, I've never actually met anyone with a photographic memory. It's interesting though, because I've been taking classes and courses and attending many non-traditional educational events and programs all of my life, probably more so as I've gotten older. But what I've always found, regardless of subject matter or educational experience, is that most of my classmates either neglect to take notes, seldom ask questions, and/or volunteer to be the first to try the thing out. That's always struck me as an odd way to learn. That is, not doing everything that you possibly could to retain the new knowledge being presented to you. Even during guided tours, for example, I carry with me a small pad of paper to jot down notes and ideas relevant to the subject at hand, or I'll carry a small digital recorder to store notes that I can later transfer to a physical notebook or document on my computer. If I don't have an opportunity to take any notes during the experience, I'll often record them afterwards with that same digital recorder. Now, I'm not saying that taking notes and asking questions is going to guarantee that you'll become an expert on the subject, and admittedly, I don't always refer back to my notes or put them to use. But I do know that if I don't take any notes at all, my chances of retaining anything from the experience lessen dramatically. So I'm that guy who scribbles everything down, asks a lot of questions, and volunteers to be the first in line. What can I say? I love to learn. But more importantly, I know how to learn, which makes learning all the more fun. You've probably heard of the four styles of learning, which are auditory, visual, kinesthetic, and reading and writing. You may have also heard that most people tend to primarily benefit from one or two of those styles, and only slightly benefit from the other two or three. But we're all human, and we all have a huge capacity to adapt and learn, regardless of our preferences and propensities. So to say that we can only learn if, is to sell ourselves short. The only if that truly matters when it comes to learning is that if you don't get involved in your educational experience, you're not going to learn it at all, period. You can't just sit in the back of the classroom or at the tail end of the pack, passively and half-heartedly participating, and expect to learn the material. In that same vein, you're also not going to become an expert just by reading a book or watching a YouTube video. So in order to truly absorb new information, you have to actively be engaged and immersed in the experience. Again, don't interpret what I've said above to mean that if you just take a bunch of notes and ask some questions, you're going to retain everything presented to you. Those are only a couple of pieces of the puzzle, and in that example, I'm simply trying to illustrate that those are ways in which you can actively be engaged in the experience, particularly if we're talking about a traditional classroom where the teacher lectures while using a visual aid such as a PowerPoint presentation. And then, for example, multiply that by the 100+ other students sitting next to you in that same lecture hall. In that type of environment, there just aren't that many ways in which you can actively be engaged, at least not while you're sitting in the classroom. But I digress. The reason I believe that all of this is challenging for many people to embrace, especially as we get older, is that it does require you to set aside your ego and become the beginner once again. You have to be willing to embarrass yourself a little bit by asking a potentially silly question or by being the first to demonstrate the technique after only having witnessed it a few times. But who cares? The rewards and long-term benefits of immersing yourself in a learning experience far outweigh any potential psychological risks involved and efforts required to learn something new and of interest to you. I also agree that being an active participant, whether in the classroom, on a sports team, or at a job, takes a lot of work. But that goes without saying. Life is hard work. But I find that, despite the amount of effort required to take the initiative, it's actually a lot easier to play an active role in life versus being a passive participant. The reason being is that by taking initiative, i.e. being active, you're living life on your own terms. Your mind, body, and spirit are able to work in partnership because you're moving in a clear direction. On the other hand, being passive means that you're always reacting to situations and usually getting caught off guard as a result. The latter approach to life and learning requires exponentially more effort to overcome the situation in question. Basically, you're just getting tossed around like a ship on the sea without a rudder. So dig in and get your hands a little dirty. Don't be afraid to demand more from your experience, but know that life is a two-way street. If you want more out of it, you have to be willing to give more. And remember that one of the many beautiful paradoxical aspects of life is that the more energy we expend doing the things that we love yields a greater capacity of energy from which we can then expend. Simply put, that which we love not only takes, but it also gives. This phenomenon shouldn't be viewed as some sort of banal financial transaction, however, where you're guaranteed a great return on your investment. There's no one-for-one trade-off in this risk versus reward equation. You simply have to have faith in the process of immersing yourself in the life experience. You may already be aware of this little secret about learning, but if not, let me share it with you in closing. And let it be known that this experience has happened to me in just about every activity that I've ever participated in throughout my entire life. People who have information and skills, particularly in niche disciplines, love to share it with people who show passion for their discipline and an interest in receiving more knowledge. Keep in mind that it's not just about taking some notes and asking a couple of questions, although that's a start. You have to be willing to dive deep. But once you demonstrate your willingness to embrace the experience, oftentimes the instructor will reward that behavior by offering even more information and personalized feedback. Those instructors and experts want to know that their wisdom and knowledge will carry on well after they're gone. More important, however, is that they have a gift to offer, but it's not for everyone. So they want to know that their gift is going to be received by the right type of person. Okay, folks, we've reached the end of this presentation, so I thank you for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed the show. If so, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any feedback or questions, post it in the comment section below. If you want to read previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com. And then check out my backcountry blog, tahotrailguide.com, where I offer information about hiking, backpacking, cross-country skiing, and snowshoeing at Lake Tahoe. I also write general and how-to articles about those activities, as well as informative articles about Sierra Nevada, flora and fauna, and the local history of Lake Tahoe. Thanks again, and take care, everyone.